What's going on, guys? I'm Jake the Lawn Kid. Welcome back to another weekend in the lawn. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to keep your lawn double dark blue green just like this in the heat of the summer. With all that being said, let's get into the video, bruh. Okay, so before we go any further, I want to go ahead and update you guys on what my lawn looks like. So as you can see behind me, this is my side yard here. And as you can see, it's looking a little, you know, just brown and dried out, which we're going to be talking a little bit about that today. So stay tuned for that. And then this is my front lawn right here. You can see nice and green. And the reason this area is doing so well compared to all the other areas is because this is really the only small plot that I commit to irrigating all throughout the summer. As you can see, I have my irrigation system all folded up over there. If you guys want to see the last video I did where I showed you guys my irrigation system and how I set it up, I will leave that here in the eye in the top right corner, as well as linked in the description below. Go check out that video to learn how to put together a cheap and simple irrigation system for your lawn with minimal cost and minimal effort. Works really well. As you can see, a couple of problems here. I have some weeds growing in here. I gotta go to the store and get some stuff to zorch those out tomorrow. But other than that, as you guys will see, my system is actually rolled up right now. So for those of you guys who watched that video, you guys were asking me, well, Jake, you forgot to mention, does your sprinkler system fold up or do you just leave it out there all the time? And the answer is, yes, I do fold it up and I do it in between watering days. My watering days are Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. What I'll do on Tuesday and Thursday is I'll go ahead and roll it up to give the lawn some time to breathe. The last thing I want to do with the configuration of my system, because I have hoses everywhere, is I want to leave the hose on the grass too long and let it burn the grass out. So it's very important that if you are going to build a system like this, which is cheap and easy, you want to make sure that you're committed to picking it up in between watering days while you can to allow the grass to breathe. So hope that answers your question. Let's continue on with the rest of the video. Okay guys, so tell me if this sounds familiar. You're coasting throughout the year, you're getting all this rain and cool temperatures, and your cool season grass is throwing a party. It just loves it, it's standing taller than ever, and it's the darkest it's ever been. Then all of a sudden, you get a few days over 90 in conjunction with a rapid decrease in the rain, and then before you know it, your lawn goes into what is called summer dormancy. And what summer dormancy is it's a defense mechanism that the lawn has to get through these stressful times. And the way it shows it is the lawn will start to dry up. More specifically, the leaf blades will start to curl up, and overall, the lawn will cast a little bit of a grayish blue color, kind of like you're seeing right now. And I am here to tell you that if your lawn is suffering from dormancy, heat stress, drought stress, hot spell, whatever you want to call it, that you have two options to go about maintaining a lawn under this type of stress going forward. Let's go ahead and talk about those right now. So the first option when it comes to summer stress, this one is pretty simple and straightforward, and that is just to let your lawn go, right? There's nothing wrong with letting your lawn go into summer dormancy. As I mentioned earlier, your lawn is not dying, it's surviving, as dormancy is a defense mechanism to help the lawn through this time. What I want you guys to understand is that while the lawn is surviving, it's in a very delicate state when it's under this stress. Thus, you want to make sure that you follow the proper protocol so that you don't cause any more damage going forward. The first thing I recommend to you is going to do with cultural practices. To be more specific, mowing. And if you can control it, I highly recommend that you decrease your mowing frequency. Now, I know that's very foreign from what I typically tell you, right? I always tell you guys, when you're not mowing your lawn enough, definitely mow it more often to stimulate more growth. But at this time, if it doesn't look broke, don't fix it. Same deal with the lawn here. If it doesn't look green, if it doesn't look like it's growing, then don't be cutting it oh so frequently. But if you are in a semi-dormancy stage, which is very common, you know, you have some low spots that just hold water longer than others, then if you're in that type of situation, then you do want to stay on top of the mowing. But what I would recommend to you guys, again, same deal with your dormant lawn, is I would definitely decrease the amount of mowings on a weekly basis. So you guys know I typically like to recommend twice to three times a week mowing your lawn. But what I would do then is I would go ahead and cut back to mowing once a week or not even at all if you can get away with it. Because again, the idea here is to decrease as much foot traffic as possible. And the second thing I recommend, while you're not mowing your lawn during this time, definitely don't consider fertilizing it either. Because like I mentioned earlier, if your lawn is under stress, the last thing you want to do is stress it some more by pushing it, right? And that's what fertilizing in the summer will do. And by the way, as you guys know, I typically do recommend fertilizing in the summer, but only in small amounts, microdosing or spoon feeding, as you guys would call it. But if your lawn is in complete summer dormancy, there is no need to feed it a speck of fertilizer whatsoever, because again, all you're going to do is stress it out and create more problems for yourself in the long run. And the third thing I recommend to you is overall, just keep traffic to a minimum or keep it off at all costs if you can control it. And I'm not just talking about mowing like I mentioned earlier, but I'm also talking about foot traffic, you know, walking on the lawn, staying on the lawn for prolonged periods. Definitely try and keep that regulated. Keep that to a minimum, because what'll happen is when you're putting all of that weight on the grass during this time, the grass is at a very delicate state. So what can happen is when you walk on it or put any kind of weight on it whatsoever, what you're going to do is you're going to crush the crowns of the grass plant. And if you guys don't know what the crowns of the grass plants are, that's basically the heart of the plant. That's the foundation that supports the lawn so that the blades could stand up tall and soak up all of that sunlight to promote more photosynthesis. So that's basically what the crowns are. You don't want to put any weight on those, because what's going to happen is you're going to crush the crowns. And when you crush the crowns of the grass plant, it's going to die. In fact, here's a couple of video clips from some of my neighboring lawns here. Some of them I maintain, some of them I don't. This is actually a week after we just got out of a 2-week dry spell. And as you can see, while the lawns are starting to come back, you can definitely see the areas that are under stress. Like this lawn right here you're looking at, this is actually my client lawn. You could see the brown streaks on there from where I've been driving my mower on it. Just not a pretty situation, right? The main objective at this time is to reduce as much traffic as possible for the good of the lawn in the long run. And the second option when it comes to riding out the summer heat wave or the hot spell or whatever you want to call it once again, is to go ahead and water the lawn. If there's anything that brings the dormant lawn back to its prime, it's water, water, water. Water is the king of all of it. Water is what helps keep soil life moving throughout this time. So you definitely want to water your lawn if you can. But before I go any further, let me just go ahead and say this. I understand if you have acres and acres of lawn and for some reason you can't keep it irrigated, maybe you don't have an irrigation system, maybe you don't have the right kind of sprinklers. I understand that, right? If you can't water it, that's fine. But what I do recommend is that if you can, pick at least one section of your lawn that you can keep irrigated throughout the summer. For example, my situation, I choose to water my front lawn. I could water the rest of my lawn, but I'm not going to because I don't feel like dealing with the extra hassle that comes with paying the water bill. So I'm more comfortable with just watering one section and letting the rest of it go. Okay, so let's get back to it. When it comes to watering your lawn in the summer, it's very important that you stay committed. And what I mean by that is once you start watering your lawn in the summer, the last thing you want to do is water for a week and then stop watering for 3 weeks and then pick back up again and start watering again, because the last thing you want to do is allow the lawn to fluctuate in and out of summer dormancy. That's just not healthy for it. In fact, it's kind of like humans in a coma. It's not healthy for a human to come in and out of consciousness, and it sure isn't healthy for your lawn. So don't make that mistake going out the gate. And as far as the actual watering goes, again, you guys have heard me say this a lot if you've been watching my videos, and that is to make sure that you water your lawn deep and infrequent. And the reason I say that is because you want to take advantage of the benefits that watering correctly will give you. Like for example, number one, you're allowing the root system to grow deeper, because when you water deep, you're allowing that water to get down into the root system where it needs to be. Whereas if you water light and frequently, what can happen is the water can stay at the surface, and instead of the roots growing down, they're going to do what I like to call the koi pond effect, and that is to grow back up where all the food and water is. So it's very important that when you water, make sure that you water deep and infrequent to promote deep root growth. And the the second benefit you're going to get from it is you're going to allow the lawn to dry out in between cycles, because while we want to keep the lawn irrigated during this time, the last thing you want to do is oversaturate it, because when you do that, you can actually flush out any existing nutrients in the lawn that are helping hold its green color and helping support its strength down below. So it is very important that when you do water, make sure that you find that happy medium where you are watering deep and you are promoting deep root growth, but you're not oversaturating it to a point where you're flushing out any available nutrients. Okay, now in conjunction with the deep and infrequent watering, one thing I recommend you do to complement that is to do what is called syringing. And what syringing is, are light, frequent waterings done at the most stressful part of the day. So a good example here would be midday. This is typically when stress is going to be at its peak level, as you have constant sunlight and temperatures are through the roof. And because of that, the lawn is going to be hot. So the objective here is we want to go ahead and cool off the lawn. So if you're noticing any small areas in the lawn that might be stressing out due to localized dry spot, or maybe because they're around a curve, a good thing to do to those areas, along with your deep and infrequent watering, is to go ahead and syringe those areas, right? If it's a small area, go ahead and hand water them for a good 10 minutes, or if it's manifesting itself intermittently across the lawn, then go ahead and kick your sprinklers on for 10 minutes at the hottest part of the day. The idea here is not to water deep, right? We're already doing that. The idea here is to cool the lawn off in the middle of the day. It's kind of like us humans once again. What do we need to do to get cool in the summertime? We need to make sure that we're staying hydrated. We need to make sure that we get some shade time. We need to make sure that we cool off ourselves. It's the same thing with the lawn, albeit they can't always get shade when they want it, right? So the one way to keep the lawn cool in the summertime, and that is to syringe areas that are stressing out more than others. So that's all I have for you guys today. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you did, please be sure to subscribe to the channel, and I will show you how to get the deepest, darkest, greenest, thickest lawn on the block. I'm Jake the Lawn Kid. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next time. If I don't see you guys next time, you're gonna be dominated, bro. See you later.